Take a rock and break it down to obtain raw silicon dioxide, which makes up most of the material. Refine this substance repeatedly until it becomes ultra-pure polysilicon, suitable for electronics manufacturing. Next, place this purified silicon into a container known as a crucible and heat it until it becomes a molten liquid. A tiny silicon crystal, known as a seed, is dipped into this liquid and slowly pulled out, allowing a larger, flawless crystal to form around it as it cools. Once the solid crystal has fully grown, slice it into extremely thin circular sheets called wafers. These slices are the foundation for building processors. The wafers are then treated with specific elements like boron or phosphorus to change their electrical behavior, a process known as doping. A light-sensitive coating is applied to the wafer, which will help define microscopic circuits. A special patterned mask is used, and ultraviolet light is shown through it onto the wafer, exposing select areas. The exposed sections go through chemical development, which removes unwanted material. The remaining areas are etched with acid, leaving behind the intricate pattern needed for circuits. Afterward, the leftover coating is washed away. At this stage, advanced techniques such as layering new material, epitaxy, further doping, adding copper wiring, and polishing are used to finalize the wafer. Finally, the wafer is cut into many individual chips, each capable of becoming a CPU. These chips are connected to external pins through microscopic wires or alternative bonding methods, allowing them to interact with the rest of the computer once packaged. And just like that, you've created a functioning central processing unit from raw materials.